some cheese on top, and we have some cucumbers and some green onions to put on top, and some eggs on the side as well.
Yes.
Okay, do you want to let them know what we're going to be talking about? Yeah, so in today's video, we are going to be reacting and giving our opinion on Am I the Asshole Reddit stories, just so that we have something to talk about while we eat. And we are also having some carritos. I'm having the pineapple and I'm having the mandarin. Okay, so let's pour the cheese.
Spice.
I did save another packet just in case.
That I should let bygones be bygones and call my mother for help.
was just trying to give her a different perspective, because she was like, look, I'm a mom, and as a mom, I see what she was trying to do. I feel like she was trying to give her another perspective, but at the same time, you can't force somebody to get over their traumas. Like, this girl clearly had childhood trauma from her mom's abuse, and you can't just force somebody, like, get over it and, like, reconcile with your mom. Like, you can't just do that. And also, if she's having problems with her husband, she should have also taken,
yeah, that too,
taken her side, you know? Like, she was upset because she didn't want to hear the truth either. So, I don't think she's the asshole. She should have worded it a different way, because she was too, what's the word? Too, like, she was persuading her to call her mom. Yes, but I feel like the girl shouldn't have been so straight up, like, telling her, your husband, you know? Like, that was a little too, what's the word?
She basically held up a mirror,
yeah,
and said, look, it's kind of the same situation, yeah, you went through.
And she got mad. So, I don't think she's an asshole.
I don't think she is either, because she knows what she went through growing up, living with her abusive mom. So, and I don't think, obviously, her friend doesn't understand.
No.
Like,
and like, her being her friend, she should have been, like, understanding and, like, not pressure her into something she didn't want to do. So she messed up right there.
Yeah.
And she just, yeah, no.
But also, two wrongs don't make a right. Like, okay, your friend offended you.
Your friend offended your friend.
Back, so it's like, come on. Like,
also, guys, I'm not the best at using chopsticks, so don't come for us.
But I'm so hungry, I'm like, yuck.
But yeah. Oh my god, I suck at using it.
Okay, so what I've seen people do is they grab and then they put it in their plate.
Okay, I'll try that right now. So we go like this.
Yeah.
And then we twist.
Yeah. You gotta kind of twist your head
like that.
Yeah.
And then we go in here.
Yeah.
There's spicy. I wait.
That was a good one though, because that kind of like made you like.
I don't know.
It was juicy.
It was juicy.
Yeah. Okay. Here, you can just choose whichever.
Okay. Okay. So, I'm a stay-at-home mom with a 1-year-old and my husband.
seems like you're really bothered that he's coming home. When it's as simple as just being like, take off your shoes before you come in.
Yeah.
Like, if you invite anybody, take off your shoes. Or just like, hey, can you wash the dishes after you're done? Because I don't want an extra mess. I feel like you just need to communicate.
Like, yeah. It looks like she was, I mean, if that was me, I would tell him, like,
what'd you do?
I just cleaned. That's the first thing. And like, second of all, not that I would be upset him coming home, because I would be happy to see him. But if it's distracting the baby, he doesn't have to go through like the whole hassle of putting the baby to bed. So I mean, maybe change the baby's nap time.
Well, my thing is, I have questions, because the baby, like, where does the baby take?
But I feel like she should have chosen a random girl that she didn't know.
Yeah.
That's like, what she just should have done. Yeah. You know, not tell her daughter anything. Just choose somebody that nobody
So Moppy. Okay, so now Moppy. I mean, first of all, before we get into it. Yeah, because I'm like, it's 2 hours.
Moppy.
Okay, Moppy. Seems like she doesn't want to work at Walmart because she has social anxiety and she's shy. He's pushing her out of her comfort zone, basically. I think that she could be like maybe working, like stalking at night.
say too much about, like if she's talking about something medical, he can't really talk about it, so he just maybe feels like out of, what's the word?
Like he has no opinion about it.
Maybe, I don't know.
I could understand how that can be annoying, like when you're trying to give your opinion on something, they're like, no, you're wrong. Like, yeah.
hands.
I would have grabbed the little boy's hand and, like, we're going to your parents.
Yeah, let's go talk to your parents. Like,
yeah.
That would have been the right thing to do. So
not, like, cuss at him or, like,
he's an asshole because he's a 4-year old.
Like, he's just a kid.
Yeah. I would. It'd be different in my eyes if it was, like, a teenager.
No.
Like, I'm a teenager. Just kidding. No. Okay.